I'm still a fan of a Daddy right Daycare 2 in like 2015 or yeah. something.
That's Daddy Day Camp, is it? Isn't it?
Is it?
No. Nope.
Danny Trejo.
There's Granddaddy Daycare, I'm pretty sure too.
Yeah, there's Granddaddy Daycare.
I think that's it.
No, it was
Is it not?
Oh no, it was a Kindergarten Cop. Kindergarten Cop.
I saw
Dolph Lundgren.
Yeah,
I saw Cop and a Half: New Recruit on Netflix. I didn't even know Cop and a Half was a movie at first.
Speaking of movies, Babysitters Beware.
Another great Danny Trejo flick.
Starring Trejo as the most prominent character.
All right, so like. You know, we are, like, okay, so, like, that movie, you know, like, we like to go on the greatest streaming app of all time, Tubi.
It's got Tubi.
Look for terrible movies sometimes. And, Babysitter's Beware starring Danny Trejo kind of gave off that vibe of, like, man, this might be a good one.
it might be a good movie. Lots of bullshit, Danny Trejo.
That movie pissed me off more than any other movie ever. Well, to be fair, okay, my least favorite movie is The Great Gatsby. The one that we saw
in
literature class.
Yeah,
I hated that movie.
I didn't have as much of a problem with it, but I can see why.
I hated that movie.
I was just confused as to why Tobey Maguire wasn't just climbing the walls.
It was, so, like, I didn't like two things about that movie. It was, like, it felt like it was edited like a movie trailer. It was just, like, everything was, like, flashing around.
I remember they used, like, modern music and,
like,
the
quote.
Yeah,
weird! Modern music, for, like, and it's, like, super... Yeah, it's, like, roaring 20s, here's some Jay-Z.
Yeah.
I'm like, why? This makes no sense. Yeah. That was... really dumb reason to hate a movie, but I disliked that movie when I watched it a lot, so I was like, okay. Oh,
I disliked this movie. I just kept getting reminded every third time I'd watch it.
But Babysitter's Beware might take the cake. I mean, like, that movie was just, like, so you have this kid that's, like, the perfect kid, and then what? Like, he gets neglected by his parents because, you know, they're busy.
Yeah, it's like, he's got the business dad.
He's doing business.
So whatever. Like, you know, like, he starts to act out because, you know, then they hire the babysitters, and he had the one babysitter he liked, but then she couldn't do anything anymore.
Because she had to study for the SATs.
Yeah.
She had a good reason.
She had to leave.
Yeah. So then, like, they hire a bunch of babysitters, but then he tortures them all, even though, like, what he's doing is just, like, they could have just been, like,
Go to your room, kid.
Yeah.
Been like,
Go to your room. I'm taking your Nintendo.
Quit being a dick.
Yeah, instead, it was literally, like, I don't know, he played the speakers loud, and it traumatized an old woman. and then, Danny Trejo is on the poster, apparently, like,
his entire
description is, like, oh, man, it's this, like, little kid is a ruckus, is causing a ruckus at the house. Until a hardened prison guard comes in and changes his mind.
Comes in and, like, sets him straight and stuff. It's like, oh, damn, this is gonna be hard. And they're like, oh, he's gonna be big deal. They call him the warden or whatever.
I can't wait to see the back and forth between the kid and Danny Trejo. That'll be fun.
Oh, I couldn't wait. I was literally, like, right when I saw that movie poster of Danny Trejo poorly photoshopped in a chair alongside the little kid from Modern Family, who's also barely in the movie, I was like, hot dog, I can't wait to see the rest of this. And Danny Trejo was in there for 20 minutes and left halfway through the movie.
20 minutes is an exaggeration.
That's generous.
It was like 5 to 10.
Yeah.
He never came back. He just, like, I don't know, and, like, he kind of gave the kid a little bit of a run for his money, but then, like, the kid just pour paint on his motorcycle.
That's the last straw.
He didn't learn any lesson. Danny Trejo, you could have taken him out of the movie. We were in the same movie. He had no point.
The lesson two is great because the lesson's just like, hey kid, if you're not getting your way, just act like a and, like, everybody's gonna start being nicer to you.
Yeah, that's how it ends. It doesn't even end on, like, a, hey, here's the lesson to learn.
Yeah, it's like, he almost gets punished a couple times, but then the dad just changes his mind.
So he's a dick to all of his babysitters, and, like, the parents are just like, oh, God, what's he gonna do? I really wish our kid was, like, actually nice, and he was just like, well, maybe I'll be nice if you're actually, like, you know, like,
yeah, maybe if you were there with me.
And then they're like, but we can't, you know, we have business stuff. And
we got, I, the dad, have business stuff, and I, the mom, am going with you to that same business stuff.
Yeah, and, like, there's, like, this weird thing where, like, okay, so he's friends with, like, this kid from Modern Family, and, like, randomly the kid is just, like, it just randomly cuts to the kid going, you're not going to my birthday party!
That was great.
And then, like,
that was a great line.
So the babysat kid, can't go to his friend's birthday party.
Before we get back to that,
whatever.
That's fine.
That was just not good.
So the babysat kid The baby sad kid can't go to his best friend's birthday party. Understandable why he's upset. You know, it's his best friend. You know,
whatever. Yeah, it's like, it's not always his best friend.
He sneaks out, he goes to his best friend's birthday party, and because, like, his parents realize, like, oh man, he's going to his best friend's birthday party when we specifically told him, oh, he can't go to his best friend's birthday party, then, like, they show up and he causes, like, I don't know, like, some...
So he ruins the kid's birthday party, and whatever. And
his parents, like, there?
They're not cool. The exact next scene... the kid's, like, makeup, he's just like, oh, wow, you made my birthday party fun.
It's like, and that was the last you ever see of the kid.
Yeah, it's like, I enjoyed that you ruined my cake, yeah. Because it made my mom all flustered.
So, like, whatever. Oh, my God. Like, the kid is kind of in deep doo-doo, whatever. And then the old babysitter that he likes comes back. But then he treats her like garbage. Like, he starts pranking her like all the other babysitters.
Because
she doesn't deserve it.
Yeah,
she's like such a nice...
nothing but, like, nice and genuine to him the whole time.
But he's
movie.
Just like, can you please call my dad and tell him that I'm being a ruckus and he'll come back? And yeah. She's just like, no, because you're not. And then, like...
And then he's like, oh, bet. And then he just, and, like, wrecks the house and, like, puts in the microwave, makes it explode, and, like, he's... throwing all this crap
yeah, so
on.
Like,
he traps her in the closet with, like, his lizard that she's afraid of. It's, like, actual psychological warfare.
God, so yeah. So then, like, I don't know. Like, he's just like, no, call my dad.
Like, call my dad. Tell him I've been bad.
No. Yeah.
Tell my dad
so
I've
then,
been bad.
So then he finally feels the need to like, spend time with me. But, like, whatever. So, like, they call his dad.
Bros.
They call his dad, and then he's just like, you know what, kid? We're bringing you to this baseball game we're going to. How about that? And he's just like... oh, yeah! And then they immediately clean stuff up. The babysitter doesn't care. Yeah. She was just tortured yeah. by this kid for no reason. There was no reason for him to torture her. So it's literally like, what's
I
the
love,
moral of this
stuff? Because like, the whole stuff. Idea is like, oh, you know, I have to go to this baseball game for a business meeting. I was going to say I'd bring the family, but you were bad, so now you're not coming. So he leaves to go to the baseball game, and then when they call him...
He's already like, on his way back.
He's
already on his way back.
He's coming back to pick him up. He's like, hey, son, yeah, I was
oh
just
God.
Kidding. I'm actually taking you to this
no.
baseball game.
Like, you're just wasting gas at that point.
It's like, hey, and guess what? I brought the clients, too.
Why?
They're in
why
the
would
car.
You
but
we didn't see the damn clients at the baseball game. It's just him and his mom just like, oh my God, finally, we're
we
a happy
we see
family.
The client, like, stand in the doorway when he, like, comes back.
Oh, yeah,
for, like,
just
30 seconds,
there.
And that's it. Dude
yeah.
stands there, doesn't say a word,
no.
and then he's gone.
But then, like, the babysitter's, like, totally fine with this kid. She's just like, oh, man, whatever his name is. He's such a nice boy, you know? He just wanted some more time with his family. I'm like, no! He literally was
it
the
was,
biggest
it was,
dick to you.
The most being... random f***ing turn of events ever, like, for the climax.
And Danny Trejo was barely in the movie!
But he was plastered over the advertising.
Yeah. And the description and everything about it. If you look it up, it's probably the first thing
at least
that'll be
the family
on
kid was at least slightly in it, but the poster...
Yeah, don't even get me started
was...
on the girl from Austin and Allie, but not Allie. The girl who had a lot of jobs.
Yeah, we know.
Yeah, that's right.
That's enough. No, you're still wait. Alive.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Toad.
Oh, look who's come to the rescue.
200 lives in, he has his first moment.
And it's a big Toad moment.
I'm gonna wait for some peach. I'm gonna wait for some peach.
Yeah, and then the baseball game, too, that like they went to, was just stock footage.
Oh,
it's
Toad.
Just stock footage of baseball happening.
As much as that movie wasn't good, it's kind of fun to watch.
Oh, Birdemic was a yeah, blast. Yeah. And then Birdemic 2 happened, and I was just like, wow.
Yeah.
It's like, they was, really...
Like, a bad movie is only really fun because, like, what, we saw the Velocipaster?
That was great.
And
yeah,
that was...
Velocipaster was awesome.
But the thing was,
like,
it knew
they,
it was
yeah, they,
bad,
they,
so I
they
didn't
knew
like
it, they
it as
knew
much
it
as something like Birdemic because
like,
it felt...
Birdemic felt, like, authentic. Like, they wanted
yeah, they
to
wanted it to be good. You know,
but like, it
like
came
the room.
Like, yeah.
You know, they wanted that movie to be good, and instead, it turned out to be.
Well, Tommy was so
ah!
wanted that movie to be good. I'm not convinced anybody else did.
Oh, Toad!
We've mastered this part. Ooh. Thank God.
Yes, he has stayed alive.
But like, you need for a bad movie, you need to have like some authenticity to the badness, where it's like. You can see they tried.
Yeah, like, it's not just, like, we're just
which
gonna...
Which makes it hilarious.
Toad,
I
dude.
Was so
fucking
close.
Toad.
When you have a bad movie that's, like, trying... Like, you can tell, like, it's too bad to be, like, not intentional, then I think that loses a lot of its charm, at least for me, personally.
D- depends on how.
Velocipaster specifically had like a joke at the very beginning where it's just like, oh, we're missing the VFX scene.
Yeah, I enjoyed that. That was a little one-off funny thing.
Yeah, it's a little one-off funny thing, but it's also like I didn't find it as charming as something like how Birdemic was just god awful.
Yeah, I will say Birdemic was more charming, but like I did enjoy Velocipaster because I feel like yeah, they knew it was corny and like weird, but like they had fun with it.
Yeah.
Like it wasn't like
there was
like,
enough dumb lines and moments to make it like, oh, that's enjoyable still.
Yeah, so I'm still
I know they're going
for
a dumb movie,
myself.
But you know.
No, but it doesn't even amount to the fucking kids movies that we saw on Tubi that were literally like I don't even know how you describe those things. Where it's literally
like
just
the
like
Hodge Saves Easter.
Yeah, Hodge Saves Easter.
And like the secret, it wasn't the secret,
no,
like
secret
of Pets, because
no,
that's
no.
like the
it was like the funny pets movie or something.
Yeah, the
like
funny world of pets or
where
something.
Where it's like they have this
world.
Dog sh CGI animation. And it's literally like they literally just have
they,
like
they cycle through the same like three animations. For the whole movie.
Well, just watching, it's literally like, just, like, voice act. It's just voice acting where they're just talking the entire time.
Like, the entire time. Like, there's no pauses.
They sit on the couch and watch the animal footage of different animals and just commentate over it.
Well, the
squirrel sure is cute, but that's no duck.
I love that line. Man, squirrels are something, but they ain't no ducks. Like, sure.
I mean, you're not wrong, but...
Keep it up. Yeah.
I mean, yeah, if I wanted a duck, but you gave me a squirrel, I'd be pissed. And then there's the all-time classic, Gooby.
Mm-hmm. I love Gooby.
That's beautiful. It's a beautiful film.
Ever seen anyone do this?
Honestly, Eugene Levy's best work.
Oh, my God. My hands are cramping.
But like I'm just shocked those movies even exist and how many of them exist specifically on Tubi.
It has to be like a money laundering.
It's gotta be like a tax write off or something. Because like a lot of
there's
their cast
no
members are the exact same names.
Yeah.
And then like I tried Googling a couple of them and I couldn't find any results.
Yeah. I loved the Hodge Saves Easter plot where it's like, oh yeah, the Easter Bunny's brother-in-law has to save the Easter holiday from
Dracula
and Frankenstein, and they only appear in one cutaway.
It sets them up like they're these huge like monoliths of like the story, but they're in one scene, and Frankenstein doesn't even say anything. He just uses the same animation that everybody else does, and he just wobbles back and forth.
But it's like, I really want to know if like there's any kids that like literally kind of grow up on those movies.
Yeah, kids
it's like
parents.
As a parent,
no.
I would never. If I was a parent, I would never like buy my kid that. Just thinking like, oh man, this looks great. I'd probably buy them like a name I actually recognize.
I mean, I think they just
Hodge Saves Easter.
I think some people just see the colorful box and the kid will point out like, I want that one, and then they're like, all right, whatever.
Well, yeah, that'll work if
what
the kid.
Fucking kid wants that.
Yeah, I don't know.
If the kid's literally like two or three, yes, that would work.
They could just see colors and be like, that's a cool one.
Yeah. It might be like, oh, I've never seen this shade of
But it's like the dialogue is like the only thing those movies have. Like, it's just like everything, like the colorful imagery, it's just repeated over and over again.
You think a two-year-old's gonna notice that?
I mean, yeah,
Do you think the two-year-old would care that the fact that it's literally just all talking? They want colorful, different imagery.
Brains have not even begun developing
they'll
yet,
consume
kind of
anything.
Children.
Like, anything put in front of them, they'll consume
like,
it.
Like, yeah, they just, like... To the point where, like, it's almost like, okay,
almost
the fact that they're speaking English is good, because that's, like, getting them used to, like,
words.
But I will say, it is still shocking to me how many movies of that type exist.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah, there's way
just,
more than there should be.
30 seconds of animation repeated over and over again, and just an hour of voice acting.
Of just nonsense dialogue, too.
Yeah, like, absolute nonsense. I did, like, in Hodge Saves Easter, though, they're, like, citing this stuff up, like, oh, yeah, there's about to be a race. Oh, wow, this is going to be crazy.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, the winner of this race gets the golden egg. Oh, man, I really hope we win this race. And it's like, haha, we won the race. Oh, no, they won the race.
Oh,
it's like the next scene. Again, there's no pauses. It's like, I really hope we can win this. Haha, we won. Oh, no, the other guys won the race. It's like, what in the actual
sh**? The thing is, like, the movies are a varying quality. The pet movie was probably the worst because all it was like really bad CGI.
Oh, terrible.
Yeah,
and
that was
then
the worst
stock
one.
Footage of animals.
Horrible CGI and actual stock footage.
Yeah.
At least with Hodge Saves Easter, like, the CGI wasn't terrible.
No,
well,
it looks okay.
Wasn't
it actually had
good,
pretty
but
solid
the model quality was
stuff.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
I think. The animation was pretty bad.
Yeah, the animation was bad, but the models looked bad. There was at least something on screen that
visually
look
looked
horrible.
Okay. Yeah,
there were visuals that
it was really weird because I think the Hodge logo probably looked like it kind of looked like f***ing Horton Hears a Who or something.
Yeah,
like that. Yeah, it looked like a Dr. Seuss logo.
Yeah,
and like I don't know, like overall,
no.
Like the opening scene, like the opening title screen, kind of looked like you were in for something somewhat quality.
Yeah.
Like at least like a little direct to DVD video. Like no, it just cuts to f***ing Hodge's dopey ass face, and he's just like, no, like Easter is.
And he's teaming up with the Thanksgiving turkey.
Oh my God.
Everybody's favorite.
Yeah.
Holiday
dynamic
mascot.
Duo. Yeah, and the Thanksgiving turkey is mimicking Richard Nixon. Just like, oh, Hodge,
I don't like the looks of this. We got the alien guys who stole.
Oh, was that Dracula? Ah, please don't
remember when we got this
again.
From Dracula and Frankenstein.
Oh, yeah, they're all in space, too.